Anything you want to do about the business, sir?
All right, I'll start. My name is Rob Evans. I'm president of IPG and have been with IPG since 1986. And I've got with me today Howard Wilton, also with IPG. If we could, I want to just kind of start very quickly. The year is 2030. So if you could just imagine with me real quick. The year is 2030.
Yeah, really enjoyed they have hotels on the exit up here, so it's a lot faster to stay down about Austin.
Did you get down to breakfast at the hotel this morning, or what did you do?
I did. Walked out of town and saw the old fire truck and produced some memorables.
Yeah, it's amazing. We walked down to the old boat house that was there. We used to go there on the team with my kids because that little round table was really fun. So we did that, but last night we went downtown and wandered around and had a little cruise in, and the fire truck was all lit up. They drove it down the road, and then we went and ate a little restaurant on the south side. It was called Rhett's. It was kind of like a takeoff on cigarettes because the O-team had this stained glass window that was really, really slick. That sort of made you kind of think, that wouldn't have been there if they hadn't done that master plan back in, what, 2016?
Yeah. The history in this town is incredible. Dig into it. It's just amazing.
So when are you heading down to the pig hen?
Jen with Jen a lot. We both, my dad was a beekeeper. Her dad's a beekeeper. Yeah, never missed us. We'll be here.
It's cool. So, you know, it's going to be cool. The 50th anniversary of the the honeybee festival is going to be incredible with this new space. All right, with that being said, there's an incredible thing that's going to happen, but how do we get there from here? All right. We went through that, 2030, what do we do? What will we do from here? What we do as architects, we master plan. We think really long term about all the causes and effects that can make you, put you in the best position you can be in so in the future, you've got the ability to know that you plan for these scenarios. These are master plans. We won a national award at Moody for their heritage park there at Moody, where old pilots can walk on there. It's a forced perspective. It's exciting. And then MLK Boulevard in Valdosta, that entire stretch is to be pocket parks, all tied to that park that's being done. There's the park from the air. There's the park, some sketches. This was in Tifton where we did a little center. There's 6 feet of fall across that site. There's no handrails. The walks just kind of meander. That's used for people use that during the weekends, fans, arts and crafts, all kinds of neat little functions right in the middle of downtown. And we designed that whole center on the top. This shows our sketching and the way we would merge. This was an old street that ran through the center of the SU. We sketched up a new plaza and, of course, the SU Boulevard turned out of that. I want to show you something kind of fun. When we work with a client, things are very personal, just like each of us are personal. Each of us individually. This is an agricultural-based charter school in Edison, Georgia. The idea here is that the first sketches that I did on that school were to create a corporate farm field specific to their needs, so that they can show that. And here's the final rendering of how the school is now going to be going into construction. Okay, so where have you been? You guys have done some incredible research to put you where you are now with your planning, and that was a great basis. At that time, in 2011, a lot of minds got together, and you came up with that plan at that time. So we're looking at that thing, okay, now what do we want to do now? I'm sure there's other things we may want to look at. So it's really exciting to see the big warehouse is gone, and there, and things are clear. So that's where you are now, sort of, but better. So when we would take our first steps, what we would do is we would say, let's get together all the interested parties, and we'll do a school, and we talk to kids about, what would you like to see in your school? Oh, I'd like a skylight. And they go, when that building is built, they buy into that because they can see that skyline. So when we talk to family, friends, community partners, that's our region, community partners, historical society, what buildings are gone that have real precedence in history that we can then capture in a new city hall. Memories. The Honeybee Committee. What challenges have they had? What opportunities have they had to let go because of lack of facilities? Precedence. What happened before? What do we want to happen? So all of this plays into the fact that it will mold and sculpt the eventual scenario that we're going to find with that city park. Here's some thoughts that we did in a vacuum. Okay, we created a train station depot stage, and you'll see it there to the side, from in the way of something. Sorry, but we also have a nice little market on one side that may have the fire truck in, may not. Maybe the fire truck is a central piece in the city hall someday. Who knows? These two schemes kind of show what could happen. The neat thing is that right here, the stage, all the folks can fan out right there. So you might have a cruise in on a Friday night and have a 50s band playing. And the next day, you've got a car show all over that lawn, and you've got food served out of this building right there. And the court, the new city hall, has a great little overlook. Maybe the boardroom has got a great view that looks back over that plaza. And folks can wander through that plaza into the bottom lawn. So, and all the parking is on the opposite side. So it is a very, very nice, open, absolutely multidisciplinary function space for your community. Here's a blow up of this. I show this little sketch from your K. Howard logo to say that whatever happens on this plaza ought to be born from context, its precedence, its history, its memories, its photographs, its all those things that folks in the community really will buy into it and know that, hey, that little bracket on that building, I had an idea because it was a picture my grandfather had of the old cigarette factory that's gone, or something else like that. Here's some sketches of possibly what this could be. This is the stage. This is a little train station context. There's the new city hall in the background, whatever that may end up being. Here's the back service side of that, where folks can bring equipment in and out and have clear access to it. On the other side, here's a neat little open market. For like market days, festivals, whatever you can imagine that we could apply to this, we will do it. When we did the municipal auditorium studies for the city of Valdosta, many, many people were canvassed as to what they would like to see. And many groups were canvassed. What would they would like to see? What could be done? So it helped mold the scope to ensure that the building would serve multiple needs as it would need to do. What's missing here? Now, we could say that, oh, we'd be nice to have a little central fountain and pavers where people can donate to the cause. Of course, the actual delineation of a future city hall. But what is missing? You guys, the community. Hey, hi. That's what's missing. We're ready to sit down with you, your stakeholders, and create your city plaza with you hand in hand. And with that, we're ready for questions.
Questions for Ms. Redden?
Good. Thank you for your presentation. So excited to be here. We came yesterday, if I'm mistaken. How are you doing?
Now, I did notice you had the concept of moving the fountain from the center where we had it up to the entrance.
Yeah. I thought about that too when I was looking at the major concept. That you had a performance on stage, that would kind of be in everybody's way. You couldn't really take up a whole area in front of the stage.
You probably have to turn it off too every time.
Yeah.
It
would be better.
neat thing about a fountain is the formality of seeing one is great. It could be a donated fountain. It could be that you fundraise for it, you find for it, you've got the infrastructure support, you go from there. But when you when we did the fountain for the MLK Park, the concern is that, you know, BSU has got some fountains, and those fountains have an expense operating. You know, so we wanted to be as frugal as we could with the fountain we did at MLK Park, because this run is 24 hours, you know, it's a, and that's worked out well, but the city know more about their expenses. The neat thing is these pieces can all be done when funding allows, but your vision ought not to be compromised in the big picture.
And these buildings can be used and designed such, on weddings, you know. I've got $2 to currently engage. So, no, it costs $10 for these things. That could be a good revenue stream.
Yeah.
And I don't take a donation.
Rob Howard, I appreciate your time.
Thank you very much. We would love to give you our thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a great day.